Let's be geographically correct. It is not Mont Blanc behind me. It's over there somewhere, but it is a beautiful sight to behold here in Les Saisies. And one by one, the competitions are ending. In the last 2 days, we've seen the end of the men's and women's biathlon. Today, the last women's cross-country event. And in cross-country, they always hold the biggest for last. For the women, that means 30 kilometers, an 18-mile rough ride. Today, for the final women's cross-country event, it was easy to see who was rooting for whom. Game faces were everywhere. Elena Valbe had hers on. The Russian set the leading pace. Would it be good enough for a fifth medal? Not if Stefania Belmondo of Italy could finish the way she started, blowing all of Valbe's times off the board. Not everyone was enjoying their 18-mile day. Elena Valbe finished and led, but would win her fourth bronze to go with her cherished gold. It was a day for Italians to cheer. Stefania, Stefania. Belmondo won the gold, completing a big triple, having already won a silver and a bronze. Lyubov Yegorova added a second silver to go with three golds. Giving up ballet as a teenager to ski has been worth it. The Italians' women cross-country effort, just over a decade old, had a quick payoff, and two members of the unified team hoisted today's champion in a display of sportsmanship to end the day.
That race just ended a short while ago, and right now joining us is Paul Robbins, our cross-country expert. Paul, were those the three best women, Yegorova, Valbe, and Belmondo, that women's cross-country has in this world?
I don't think there can be any question about that, Al. They're going home with 13 medals, gold, silver, and bronze. They've got them all.
Now, Belmondo wins the three medals. The Italian cross-country relay team comes in third. We're looking at a program that's just about a decade old. Why can't the United States, who's been in the sport for so much longer, do what they're doing?
Well, U.S. coaches are asking themselves the same thing. With that kind of commitment, they can do certain things, but you also need the bucks, and the Americans need the dollars.
Well, after the big five-event Olympic showdown, what's the state of the union now in women's cross-country skiing?
Well, I think if we've seen one message that's come through, it's that if there is a new world order, it hasn't come to cross-country skiing, because you've still got the Soviet non-union at the front of the women's parade, along with a very talented Italian.
One more personal note. In just a matter of days, Raisa Smetanina of the unified team will turn 40. At these games, she won her 10th Olympic medal. That meant we had one last chance to see her ski and to salute the greatest medal winner in the history of the Olympic Winter Games. That's the report from Les Saisies. Let's go back to Harry.